In this video, we do an application problem that uses exponents and our logs to solve. And so we do this problem on this video. Use the compound interest formula to find how many years it takes $1,300 invested at 9% compounded monthly to increase to $2,000. So what this means is if you put $1,300 in a bank, and the interest rate is 9% and it's compounded monthly, which means 12 times a year. When is the value in that account at $2,000? So what we want to do is identify what we do know and be able to, and use this formula here. So P stands for the original investment. A is how much it is after a certain number of years. So let's fill that in. We know that P is our original investment of $1,300, and A, we want to find out when it's grown to $2,000. All right, what about the interest rate, R? Well, that's 9%. We want to write that as a decimal or a fraction. So it's 0.09. And we don't know the time, right? But N is how many times per year the interest is compounded. Since it says monthly and there's 12 months in a year, N is 12. So we want to fill all these numbers into this formula, and then we will compute and find out what T is. So let's do that. So we have A, well, we're going to plug in 2,000. P is 1,300. And we have 1 plus 0.09 divided by 12, because that's R over N, to the NT. So N is 12, so it's 12T. So that's the original part of the problem. Now from here, there's different ways you might, you know, simplify this, but I'm going to start by simplifying inside parentheses and at the same time dividing both sides by 1300. So if I divide both sides by 1300, okay, I'm just going to leave that as 20/13, okay, on the left side, 20/13, because it reduces pretty easily. 20/13 equals, and now I have to simplify inside this parentheses, because now I have a 1 in front of here. So I could write 1 as 12 over 12. Is everybody with me there? 12 over 12. So I'd have a common denominator. So that means in the fraction, I would have 12.09 over 12 to the 12t. So this is what I have so far. Okay. At this point, if you can divide 12.09 divided by 12 and have it not being a repeating decimal, then you could do that. If you get something that 12 doesn't go into evenly, then what you would do is just leave it as is. But in this case, if you do use your calculator, 12.09 divided by 12, you get 1.0075. It does come out to an exact number here, to the 12t. But notice 20/13. If I try to divide that out, it doesn't come out exact. So if something doesn't come out exact, leave it in fractional form. All right, so here's the problem. We're now going to try to solve for t, and t is in the exponent. And the key is anytime you have a variable in the exponent that you're trying to solve for, you're going to use logs. You're going to take the log of both sides, or the natural log of both sides. So we're going to go on to the next page to continue this. So this is what I have, and it's up to you whether you want to use your log button or your natural log button. I'm just going to use the log button. So I'm going to write the log of the left-hand side is equal to the log of the right-hand side. Now if you want, you could put brackets around here, but it's certainly not required. All right, so now if I have this 12t, what I could do is, since it's in the exponent, I could put it out in front of the log. So really, it's kind of confusing seeing these brackets, but I showed it just that I'm saying I'm doing it to both sides. So what do we have now? I've got this log of 2013. So it's okay, don't worry about it. Just keep writing it. And we're going to bring 12t out to the front times the log of 1.0075. Okay, now the trick here is you're trying to solve for t. So remember, the log of 1.0075, that's just some number multiplied by t, and then I also have 12 by t. So what I've got here is the log of 20/13, and I'm going to write this so you see this as a coefficient, times 12, and I have 12 log of 1.0075 times t. So what I want you to note is that this part here is simply the coefficient of t. So we're just going to divide both sides by that number. So I'm going to divide the right side and the left side. So I don't do any rounding until this very last step. And keep in mind, this is the log of 20/13 divided by 12 times the log of this. You can't combine this 20/13 with this 1.0075. These are two separate computations you're going to have to make to solve for t. Now we put that in the calculator very carefully with parentheses, etc. So in the calculator, I would recommend you put like a bracket around the log here, and then a parentheses around the 20/13, another bracket, then a division sign, and then another bracket, 12 times the log of this. You want to make sure that you're very careful how you enter this in your calculator. So go ahead and try entering this in your calculator and see what you get. It might take you a little while to enter all that. And this is what I got in my calculator, so I'm going to put approximately because now it's not going to be exact. It does go on and on. I got 4.8044, and it kind of goes on and on, but it did say round to the nearest tenth of a year. So I'm going to say that t is approximately 4.8 years. And in fact, I'm going to, since it's a word problem, it takes about 4.8 years, which was the question. Says how long did it take, right? How many years? Okay. Wow. Not an easy problem. Now at this point, I would suggest actually checking to see if this seems correct. So let's go back to the original problem. So here's the original problem. We already identified PR, A, and T. But what I want to do is now see if actually you invested this $1,300 at 9% at, compounded monthly for 4.8 years. Is it really $2,000? So that's what I mean by checking. So I'm going to try that. So I'm going to say, well, what is A? And the question is it going to come out to $2,000? That's what we would hope. So what would P be? Well, that's a 1300. And I have 1 plus, my R is 0.09, divided by 12 again, to the NT. So it's 12 times. Now I'm going to actually plug in that number, 4.8. Okay, so we're just going to simply compute what happens if you put $1,300 in for 4.8 years at this interest rate compounded monthly. So again, we want to simplify inside this parentheses, which was, I think, 1.0075. And 12 times 4.8 is 57.6. So that's how many times it actually gets compounded. And now we're going to use our calculator to do the 1.0075 to the 57.6 and then multiply it by 1300. Or if you're careful, you could go 1300 times. Make sure you use parentheses to do this. So go ahead now and just see what happens when you simplify that. Be careful of your order of operations. I usually go ahead in my calculator just to make sure I do this first. And so I could put my calculator 1.0075 raised to the 57.6. That you do that according to your calculator, and then I press enter. And if you do that, you should have something about 1.537854, etc. And then I just go ahead and multiply by the 1300. Next, and that gives me 1999.21. Okay, well, that's not exactly $2,000, right? We want to see if it's about $2,000. And of course, it's not going to be because this 4.8 was rounded. But it checks because that's pretty darn close, right? So we must have, when we rounded under a little bit. So that's why when we plugged it in, we got a little bit smaller number. So now we verified that that does make sense, about 4.8 years. So that takes about 4.8 years was the answer to this problem.